checky the mic. Here we go with the intro. Hello, and welcome to my video. I'm totally not tired. I really think my editor should be fired, but I don't have one.
Hello! Hi guys, Terrorizer here. I'm really tired. Today's video is sponsored by EA. They were awesome enough to fly me all the way on the other side of the planet to Cologne, Germany to play Battlefield. And look at this.
Hey, Brian.
Oh no, I've already done it.
I was so goddamn tired at this event. The jet lag had kicked my ass, but I was determined to show I am full of energy and I can't even get in the center. Did I just pick my... That is fucking disgusting. So I don't normally do commentary videos, so I guess I'm just gonna talk you through this amazing gameplay. I see this guy on the horse. The horses are a lot of fun to use, but I have to put him down. But I put down the horse. I murdered a horse. Then level cap, I see him going up this ladder. I get some hit markers on him and got right, okay, he's weak. Have to chase him up, go up there. And here he is waiting like a pyromaniac with a flamethrower. I kill him, and then, yeah, I'm toasted. Yeah, I'm not happy there. Oh, here's a kill, no. Yo, I'm on fire, as usual. Yeah, I'm on fire. I showed this part because look how big, look how vast this map is. This game is really just all about teamwork, completely about teamwork, and you actually don't care about dying, which is really refreshing. And look how epic that looks. So amazing. I will give you guys some advice. Do not aim down sights too much. I found, obviously with longer distance, but hipfire is your friend in this game. Well, for me, I was definitely a lot more successful. You'll see a guy here around the corner. Hit fire, get some hit markers, and then someone unfortunately stole the kill on me. But the reloads, time your reloads. I got caught with my pants down a lot. Oh, 97, and I die. I was not happy there. Yeah, just a little disclaimer. I'm not used to doing FPS games with the massive keyboard. Don't kill the horse, please don't kill the horse. There you go, see, I'm getting better. Did not kill the horse that time. It was at this point I really think I was really getting into the game, and I'm feeling it. I'm like, man, got a few kills under my belt. I'm about to show everybody what Terrorize is really about. Let's do this. Son of a bitch! And here's a perfect example of when reloading is a thing. You need to reload and not go around with a half-empty magazine and give this guy the opportunity to be a goddamn magician, and he's just after disappearing. So I'm running around this house looking for this guy, and then I go outside and I'm being shot at. Now, hide in the corner and heal. Then reload your goddamn gun and get caught with your pants down, and look who comes in with a trench shotgun. Yes, of course, it had to be.
I hate white boy.
This is the point where I discovered aeroplanes in this game, and here's a little tip. Do not use the mouse and keyboard. I find it very difficult because trees and your left wing do this. Yep. I said that.
But then Brian realized the Xbox controller was so much easier.
So at this point, Adam and I realized how amazingly fun airplanes can be right there. So what we did was we pretty much spent the next while jumping into an airplane, going into third person. That's the main thing I didn't realize was a huge help. And you can see each other much easier. And we were just goofing around, having fun like this. But this next part is what I thoroughly love doing. Get into third person, looking for a person on the ground, and doing what happened to me. And there's nothing more satisfying than this.
Ah, yes.
So for the remainder of this video, I want to do something I don't think I've really ever done, but I just want to commentate over the gameplay, be, you know, chillax, sit back, talk to you guys, be honest, and talk about two different things. I'm going to talk about Battlefield 1 itself, and also as to why I've been away, haven't been up on, wait, I have a burp about to happen. Bless me! Wow, I'm so professional. But look, alright, so Battlefield 1, as a game, this is what's going to happen a lot. See the way I killed someone and died almost instantaneously. That's something that happens a lot. I think it happens right here too. So I'm, you know, trying to run away from the battle. You're also going to see like a person just out of nowhere. You're going to catch them from the side or behind. You're going to get killed. This game is not about kill-dead ratio. So if you're going to go in with the mindset of getting an amazing KD, I wish you all the best, because it's not going to happen that often. Unless you find a tank. tanks are definitely the people who are seeking that high kill death ratio on the scoreboard at the end of the game. Find a tank, stay in it for the whole game. Whatever you want to do. I wanted to get out there and just have a bit of fun. Try out all the different weapons. The LMG is a lot of fun. Tanks. Horses are definitely my favorite. But something like this was absolutely hilarious. When you're in panic mode, you can do a last-ditch effort to try and bayonet stab a guy with, a melee kill. But unfortunately, he got blown up right in front of me, and I just got destroyed by a tank. But there's going to be glimpses of amazing gameplay from me right here. For some reason, everyone has his mindset. Brian is an absolutely terrible video gamer. He's so bad. I'm actually not. I'm actually quite decent. I hold my own in first-person shooters. I've always have. Normally finish in the top part of every multiplayer, first-person shooter game when I'm in a lobby. Most people that have jumped into lobbies with me will see that. I'm actually not bad. Unfortunately, I got picked off there. But hopefully you guys will see from this gameplay, I actually went on a bit of a tear. This is all the one game where I just, for some reason, was just kicking booty, I guess. And the game got really close, got very competitive, got super into it. I think I held my own, considering that everyone else that was in this lobby, all the YouTubers that were flown out to Cologne, Germany, were also the ones that were flown to Los Angeles for E3, and also for, they got the alpha access. I didn't. This was my first ever time playing Battlefield 1. And also, I'm not really accustomed to using a keyboard and a mouse. So, all things considered, I think I did a pretty good job, and I was quite proud of myself, taking all that into the equation. But yeah, now let me know in the comment section what you think. Did I do okay? Did I hold my own? Am I just terrible? Are the rumors true that I'm a bad video gamer? But like I said, hipfire. Hipfire, guys. That's all hipfire. Do not use ADS. It kept screwing me over all the time. I could be just bad using ADS. Could have been just the wrong gun, but I definitely found using hipfire running around with this. I can't even remember the name of this weapon, but I liked it. It was absolutely wunderbar. But enough about that. The game is fantastic. Horses are hilariously fun. Oh yeah, this gets really, really close down to where, look, 3 seconds, we're tied. It makes it to the very end, and that was insane. That was a hall with 2,000 people that just went crazy when that thing went down to the wire and to a draw. So yeah, and also I want to thank EA again for honestly bringing me out. I had an absolute blast. I hope to do this again. Hint, hint, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Because this was a totally new experience for me. I'd never been surrounded and flown out to one of these events by a company like EA. So it was an awesome feeling for me. So thank you again to EA. But this part was not so amazing. Okay, we've killed the guy on the horse, but our teammate just kept shooting Seabiscuit and put it down. And we run him over. Everyone in that exchange died. It was brutal. But enough about Battlefield 1. Great game. Again, thank you so much for flying me out of EA. Had an absolute blast. But for the remainder of this video, I kind of want to just, explain as to why I have not been uploading. A lot of people have been tweeting me saying, what's happened? Why are you not uploading? I was just not in the right mental state. Now, I was not depressed. I was not anything like that. So don't think, I was in a bad place or anything like that. Just after all this traveling, when I flew all the way to Germany from the west coast of America, and when I was in America, I was doing a bit of traveling up and down between LA and doing stuff, I just physically and mentally was exhausted. That's just the easiest way to put it. I was just tired, and when I got back to Ireland from Cologne, Germany, I had 2 days before I had to be flown out to Birmingham to do Insomnia, which was 4 days of just long days, amazing days, don't get me wrong, amazing days, but very tiring at the same time. So I have just been exhausted, and I've tried so hard to, get back to editing, but because I was so tired and exhausted, I think my immune system was weak, and then I got sick the past few days. But right now I'm feeling good. I want to get this video up and then start on the next video and just get back to the videos, get back into the swing of things. So again, thank you so much for being patient. And thank you guys for sticking around and watching my videos day in, day out, and allowing me to be able to go out with EA and play video games in Cologne, Germany like that. That means a lot to me. My channel has been something I'm very proud of, and I'm very proud of you guys. I'm very proud to say you guys are my viewers. And Insomnia 58, you guys blew me away, honestly. No words can describe the amazing feeling it was to see the sheer volume of people that came out to, grab a picture and get an autograph and buy my t-shirts. Dude, honestly, the amount of people that bought merchandise just absolutely blew my mind. I did get a tad emotional. I will be honest. And I'm not saying that, to pander to the audience, but you guys really, really made me, like, very emotional in the back, just thinking, you know, wow, how far have we come where I've got this big screen with my videos and my logo and t-shirts being bought, and I'm just like, never in my wildest dreams when I sat down watching, like, Machinima Respawn videos, watching C-Nanners, and here I am killing him off of a goddamn horse. I'm playing with him in Germany, and, you know, it's been a crazy, crazy ride for me, and I want to say thank you, because without you guys, I wouldn't be able to take this ride or make this ride. You guys are everything. I want to say thank you so much. I really want you guys to know how much I appreciate it. I'll stop doing that now, because then I just sound like I'm just kissing your asses. But again, thank you so much. But yeah, I'm back. I'm hopefully going to be uploading a lot more. Just need to start planning things when I start traveling, because, you know, luckily I was surrounded by the right people, such as Sean Anders, who it gave me some advice about traveling. You need to prepare yourself for this, because YouTube is no joke. And actually, I'm gonna, you know, interrupt myself, because this right here was actually a good showcase of sniping ability by myself. So I think in the comments section, let me know if this was impressive or not. And also, my capture card unfortunately started skipping the gameplay. There's a bit of a corruption with the recording, so if you see a flicker or anything like that, that's just unfortunately what happened with the recording. But I think you see most of the gameplay. This part annoyed me. I think here, he goes prone just as I shot, and then I missed him because another guy spawned on him. But I pick up, sorry Dalek, Dalek's, that's another YouTuber you should check out, sorry John. But yeah, I think I did good. The sniper, it's all about finding what gun works with you. I can't remember the name of this this carbine, I can't remember the name of this rifle, but it was more powerful than the others. I really enjoyed using it, but I was just, yeah, look, I was in no man's land there, I was going to die. But yeah, I'm going to wrap things up here. I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope I didn't do too terribly as a commentator. Let me know what you thought of this video. Tried to keep it funny and also a bit, you know, informative. So yeah, stay awesome, guys. I hope you enjoy this final concluding bit of gameplay. Stay awesome and enjoy this epicness that is the Horseman. Peace. Jurassic.